Welcome to the Anime Association. My name is Jack from Under the Scope Reviews, and with me today are Lou from Lou Talks Anime.
Oh shit, what up?
Dakota from Dakota Broski TV.
Oh god, I knew I would be next, and I was so not ready. Hi, how you doing? That's okay. All I got.
And Random from Anime Opinions.
Hey guys, it's Random Simon 613. What's going on?
Today, we are going to be talking about shitty criticism. Like, buzzwords that people use too often when they're trying to trash a show that need to go away. So, too often I see the same lame criticisms hurled at series in cases where they don't apply, or like, the go-tos people use when they can't think of anything meaningful to say. So, this podcast is going to be spent trashing on these criticisms, and hopefully, you think twice before you use some of these next time. Does anyone want to start?
Fuck the word pretentious.
Yeah, I was going to say, should we just start out strong?
Yeah, dude, now we gotta swing for the fucking fences.
Yeah, I was gonna say, shit, we're gonna meteor jam this fuck.
Pretentious needs to fucking die.
Yeah, more often than not, when that word is thrown around, no one bothers to elaborate on it. They just take it as a matter of fact. Which, that's the worst part of any buzzword, is that the implied meaning is they assume carries so much weight that they completely ignore the fact that not everyone agrees and things... In the context of discussion, in an open forum like comments, are meant for explanation to discuss your opinions. And so, the word pretentious is probably the biggest offender of all that.
Exactly. Like, if a show tries to portray anything remotely intellectual or meaningful, people will automatically slap the pretentious label on it.
We should probably start with what pretentious actually means, because it doesn't get used properly ever. Basically, pretentious actually means attempting to impress by affecting greater importance, talent, culture, etc. than is actually possessed.
So you got that nice Google definition there, huh?
I did. Thank you, Miriam.
The same
Webster.
Thing pulled up.
Yeah. So I think the thing with pretentious, with calling something pretentious, is they're trying to devalue it by saying, "Oh, it's trying to be more than it is." The problem is that a lot of the shows that get that label aren't trying to be more than they are. They're just trying to have, I think, more... Oh, what's the word I'm looking for? Trying to have like a deeper meaning than your average anime.
Exactly.
And I think that doesn't come off well with the average audience.
It's like, pretentious is when it's acting like it's meaningful when it isn't really, just to sound impressive or like sound smart. Mm-hmm. Whereas most of the shows that get that label are just actually meaningful. You know,
should
it also gets like, into the thing like
Evangelion.
Yeah,
like what are some examples of shows that you've seen this criticism thrown at? Like
Serial Experiments.
Like Ava is the obvious.
Ava's the obvious.
Yeah,
yeah. I think Monogatari
Technolize.
Gets it too.
Monogatari gets it. Yeah,
but you want when I've seen it, I've also seen it used completely incorrectly. Like I know we went over the definition. But, I mean, more often than not, it's just dismissive of the value that it's trying to develop and it's trying to present. But there are some people that just don't know the definition of the word and just know that it's an insult.
I think so.
And that bothers me.
Yeah, I think I've heard it used on
Madoka. Like, if you're going to use a word, learn what it fucking means.
Yeah. Exactly.
Like I've heard Kaon called pretentious.
Oh my god.
Which that's not
I don't understand why.
That's not the word I would use for Kaon.
I've heard Kaon called many things. Pretentious is not one of them.
I've seen it happen once and it like I got mad. I was probably trolled pretty hard, but still.
I mean, from my understanding, Kaon is not pretending to be anything other than what it is. It's not trying to have some hidden, deeper meaning. It's basically a story about friendship.
I mean...
Yeah, no, I mean, like, yeah. It's not to say that the story isn't meaningful, because I would say that the story is very meaningful, but what you see is what you get, you know? Like, it doesn't coat that meaning in, you know, false philosophical bullshit or anything like that. It's lays it out right on the line.
Unless somebody expected to be, like, actually thought it was going to be about music.
Yeah, that's a common misconception right there.
You should watch Mongolian Chop Squad for that.
Yeah, or if you want something in the KyoAni wheelhouse, just watch Euphonium. But, K-On! Is not about, like, a band struggling to get better and improve. That's something that a lot of people go into the show expecting that and then walk away disappointed when they get the opposite.
They get cute girls being cute.
Yes.
I've heard people actually use, now that you said something about pretentious, I've actually heard somebody say it for Madoka Magica. And I'm starting to see a trend now. Like, a lot of people are using it for, I would say, deconstruction shows, really.
A deconstruction is another word that gets thrown around too much in general.
Yeah.
It's not a criticism, but people just slap it on everything nowadays. You know,
it's one of those, there's a difference between satire and deconstruction there.
Yes, huge difference. Like, Konosuba was satire. I would not call it a deconstruction.
Madoka actually is deconstruction of a genre.
Yes. Yeah. Now, but another problem with deconstruction that's like sort of the same side, or the flip side of the same coin, is that just being a deconstruction doesn't automatically mean that it's good. Just like, you know, people slap pretentious on something and then just assume that that's true.
No, I totally get what you're saying, though. Because, like, for example, before I watched Madoka, I was in threads, I think it was on R Anime, and people were saying, oh, you know, it's a deconstruction, it's great. But without elaborating on what it was deconstructing from its genre, which, again, this conversation is about throwing around buzzwords. And that's one that, I don't know, I think the problem is there haven't been enough shows that didn't receive acclaim that were deconstructions of a genre. Like, I can't think of a deconstruction that is bad, but I think it's wrong to assume that all deconstructions are good.
In the same way, yeah, that,
exactly.
Yeah.
What are some shows that get the pretend that you guys actually legitimately think are pretentious?
Akame ga Kill.
Elaborate. I haven't seen it. I know.
Elaborate. I don't want to watch it.
You're not missing anything. So, Akame ga Kill purports to actually have a deeper meaning behind how it has all of its characters, sorry, spoilers, die through all these things that are supposed to create a stronger emotional connection to move along the story. The problem is that it's trying to be Game of Thrones, and it fails miserably because there's no connection with the characters that die. Because they move, specifically the anime, I haven't read the manga, so I can't speak to that. But it moves along too quickly to develop any kind of connection with the characters that are killed, so you don't get that Game of Thrones feeling. So, and it's trying to be Game of Thrones is the feel that I got from it.
Oh, okay. There was one death in that show that kind of made my heart flutter, and then my brain was like, what the fuck are you doing? Kill that. That, you understand what's going on, right? But it was the one I can't remember what episode on. I think it's like 15 or something, but it's the one with the I can't spoil it random, but you know what I'm talking about. The how do I explain it without, I'm just typing it in the chat.
Broski, you can just spoil it. It's fine. I think we're at statute of limitations.
Oh. Then the big brother, the guy who said called him Big Brother.
Oh, yes. That particular,
because I was like, the only character I actually fucking loved is in this dumbass show.
Yeah, that
show
was probably one of the few deaths. It's in this whole stupid quasi Game of Thrones situation when the mentor gets killed. That was actually a pretty decent death, and that's probably the only good death in that entire series that actually moves along the plot in some meaningful way.
Pretentious.
Exactly.
I'm trying to think of, the thing is, I try not to be negative on a lot of shows, so it's like, I'm trying to come up with a show that I legitimately think is pretentious, and nothing is really coming to mind. Like, all the ones that are, I guess, the standards for being considered pretentious. I think I've seen enough, or I've seen them enough times that I more or less grasp what they're going for and can more or less justify it. I guess maybe Shinsekai Yori.
Yeah, but I mean, even that has, but, you know, like, still has legitimate meaning to it.
No, absolutely. But I mean, this is me struggling to come up with an answer. And that's like the only thing that I think even remotely is pretentious.
And that's part of the reason why I think this is such a word that just needs to die, is because pretty much every time I see it used, I completely disagree.
Can pretentious be...
it's not being used correctly. I mean, I could argue...
I was going to say, can pretentious be replaced with trying too hard?
Yeah, it's kind of the same idea, because they're trying to be something that they're not. They're trying to be more... They're trying to be deeper than they are, basically. And the root of pretentious is they're pretending, essentially.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They're pretending to be more than they are.
Yeah, it's like if you use like a shit ton of big words to try to sound smart, you know,
exactly.
That would be pretentious.
If you don't like big words, come over to my channel. I don't use any of them.
Or if you, you know, like if you pretend to like a bunch of shows to try to give off this cool, smart vibe, then that would also be pretentious.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. And the number of shows that actually try and... Oh, that was the show I was going to bring up. The show that thinks it's a lot smarter than it is Perfect Insider is definitely a show that I would slap pretentious on in a heartbeat.
I remember some of the dialogue in the first episode was just like...
I completely blocked that show off.
Yeah.
Like,
maybe that's why we're having a hard time. Because we've tried to delete these shows from our mind.
Yeah, I watched all of it and it kept... That show was a lot of talking and no substance. And it drove me insane.
And that's the biggest problem. Like, that's when something is really pretentious, when there actually isn't any substance. And, yeah, and, like, mm-hmm. in, like, almost all these cases, at least all the ones I can think of or have seen, there usually is substance if you actually look and don't just dismiss it as, oh, three deep, five me, you know?
Yeah, exactly. That's the problem with the way it's used in the community.
All right, Jack, you had other words on your list. I'm curious.
Oh, yeah, I've got a big list here. The next one, and some of you, I don't know if everyone will agree with me, but I, in general, almost always hate when people use slow pacing as a criticism. And sometimes it's true.
Ooh, Jack.
And this is where we need to highlight that context is important. Because for some of these criticisms, it's absolutely true. And it's a totally valid criticism. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about when people just use it as either as a go-to when they can't think of anything, or as if slow pacing automatically equals bad pacing. And I completely disagree with that.
Yeah, they're not equivalent.
Yeah.
Because in the case that I always bring up for slow pacing being bad pacing is Attack on Titan. I think the pacing is trash.
Whereas slow pacing being good, I would say, is Mushishi would be a clear example of that.
Yeah, that's a great one, yeah.
Exactly. That show is paced to perfection with the subject matter that it goes with.
Actually, Jack, I think it's gotten even worse.
That's another show that gets called pretentious, I believe.
Yeah, I think it actually got worse, too, because people are just starting to say pacing now instead of slow or fast. It's just pacing. The pacing is bad.
Oh, yeah, that's when you know it's the classic go-to. They just say pacing's bad.
Okay, how so? Please elaborate.
Yeah, exactly. That's the problem.
It doesn't
if you can
move
tell me
good.
Why the pacing is bad, if you can tell me why something, you know, why you think that criticism fits, then that's fine. It's just when you just, you know, these blanket statements and slapping it on, you know, every show just because you have to come up with some criticism, right? You know, and also we're not referring to, like, you know, brief Twitter comments where you are limited to a certain number of characters and can't elaborate, but if you actually have the opportunity to elaborate on your stance and you don't, and all you say is, oh, pacing's bad, no.
Or even just a YouTube comment where you don't have that 140 character restriction where you can actually elaborate.
Yeah, you have 500 characters in a YouTube comment. Get creative.
Yeah, and YouTube comment sections is where you'll find a lot of these buzzwords too.
Well, we all know don't read the comment section.
Yeah, no, that's a rabbit hole you generally don't want to go down. But
it's worse than Facebook comments.
Like an example of a show that came out like within the last year or so that was just absolute garbage pacing. For me was Charlotte, just terrible.
Yeah,
just so rushed. I mean, rushed beyond comprehension, to the point where it was hard to even follow what was going on, and any emotion and impact that, like, the end of the series could have had was completely destroyed by how rushed it was. You know, that's an example of pacing that actually fits as a criticism. But you guys mentioned Mushishi. Another couple shows that I think slow pacing works in would be Hyoka, which I don't think anybody else here has seen, and Shiki. I don't know if you guys have seen that one. And I know some people would disagree with me on Shiki, but the first, like, 12 episodes or so of that show are super slow. But in its case, I think it actually works to build the world, and it's a horror, and heighten the level of, like, suspense and tension. And so, yeah, basically my point is just that, like, slow pacing does not equal bad pacing, and people need to stop using it as such. And just whenever someone says, oh, bad pacing, then people automatically take it at face value and say, oh, yeah, he's right. Yeah, this sucks.
Oh, you got no argument for me?
No argument.
Yeah, I think we're all on the same page there.
Yeah, definitely.
Does anybody want to go next, or we can move down to the next one on my list?
I honestly don't have a list.
Okay. I honestly, like, think that your list is all we got, man. We'll just go off of you, because you pretty much, I think,
that's
I'm
cool.
Assuming
I mean, these,
you hit all the right ones.
These are all words I've seen used so much. Yeah, I you know, I tried to make sure I got all the big ones I could think of, at least. But yeah, no, these are all words that I've seen used so much, and to the point where I was tempted to just do rants of them in videos, but this is much easier to get them all out of the way. So,
in full disclosure, this was Jack's idea, everybody. Yeah. So don't go raging at anybody but Jack. His Twitter is at UTSReviews. By all means,
please
blow
bring on the rage. Bring on the rage, yeah.
He's also at youtube.com/...
under the scope
reviews. UTS reviews.
The only catch is that you have to...
That's a comment section.
Yeah, the only catch is that you can't use any of the words that we use today in our arguments against him.
Exactly, unless you can use them correctly.
Unless you can use them correctly. Unless you can give us a paragraph of, like, why.
Actually, bonus points if you use every single word I mentioned in your comments.
No, see, what I actually expect to happen is the comment section on this particular video to be filled with people just calling us pretentious.
I am pretentious.
You guys are pretentious.
I'm a pretentious wanktar. Get the fuck over it.
Under the pretentious.
I know thing. I am.
No, we're taking this too seriously. We're just, yeah. No, we're too easily triggered.
I take my Chinese cartoons very seriously.
I take them pretentiously.
Okay. All right, so the next one, and this one I barely even understand. Forced drama. What does that mean?
Okay.
I think what they're going with for that is that the drama that was introduced was only there for the sake of having the drama.
Or it was ran
as opposed to it
that's
organically
what
occurring.
That's what
I
would think. But unfortunately I see the phrase forced drama levied at every single show that has drama in it. Regardless of whether, you know,
so
even shows
something
that
like
are like pure dramas just gets up forced drama. You know, it's sort of like pretentious.
No, like something like Nagiyasu. I've definitely seen that thrown at Nagiyasu.
Oh, yeah.
Except
which
the fact
is
that
a show that's built on drama.
Yeah,
I mean, it's a work of fiction, so of course it's fucking forced.
Yeah,
that's
but I that drama occurs naturally within the context of the series, so that's not a valid criticism.
I mean, if you're gonna, you know, if you think of it like that, all drama is forced because the writer is creating it. You know, the author
exactly.
of the work is creating the drama. Therefore, all drama is forced. You know, yeah, Nagiyasu is definitely one. Clannad is another one. But yeah, basically any drama, like every single drama.
I think any
gets
of the key
forced.
Adaptations had that levied at it. All
oh, yeah.
the key adaptations.
Oh yeah, all of them would get that one big time.
Which, to be fair, they're not wrong, but. You know, I'm not a fan of. I don't think any of the adaptations they've done. So
yeah, you know, I'll fight you to the death over Clannad. But
I haven't watched Clannad, so I have no opinion on it yet.
I haven't watched past episode 9 for the past 4 years.
There's actually another key adaptation coming up, like next season, I think. But anyway, this is beside the point. We don't.
Is it the second season of Charlotte? Please tell me
the
second season of Charlotte. No.
It's a visual novel adaptation. Which is the first time they've done that
so
in a while,
Charlotte,
actually.
But...
No more Charlotte. That's why people are actually more hyped about this one, because it isn't just like June Maeda.
Forced drama and pizza sauce?
And pizza sauce. Lots of pizza sauce, yeah.
All the pizza sauce. Pizza sauce for life, man.
And forced drama kind of leads into another one, which is melodrama. And this one's probably going to give me a lot of hate. But I think that melodrama is all often used just as an automatic, melodrama is always bad. And I don't think that's necessarily true. I think that's kind of misconstruing what melodrama actually is.
Well, elaborate, please, Jack.
Okay, like...
like, in terms of what exactly is melodrama, and what instances are you seeing this criticism thrown at it?
Okay, basically... okay, well, the key adaptations would be the primary suspect.
I can give you the definition of melodrama, because I'm ready for this.
Go for it.
So, melodrama is a sensational dramatic piece with exaggerated characters and exciting events intended to appeal to the emotions.
Yeah.
Thank you, Merriam-Webster.
And, I mean, what in that definition, like, makes it seem like it's some sort of inherent wrong thing about a story, you know?
It's not.
Yeah.
It
gets kind of confused. I think people use it interchangeably with emotionally manipulative.
Exactly.
Which is also another one.
Or maybe cheesy.
Yeah.
Yeah, cheesy. Well, melodrama is cheesy. That's kind of its point, but... There's good and bad melodrama.
Exactly. Yeah, no, yeah. My point is that melodrama, like, isn't an inherent wrong about something. Now, I would say more often than not, it's probably bad. Just because it's really easy to make something super cheesy and way over dramatic and...
Well, I would go a step further and say more often than not, anime in general or media in general is bad. The percentage of what is good media is small compared to the rest of its medium.
What is that, Sturgeon's Law or whatever?
Yeah, 90% of everything is shit.
Yep. Yeah.
I mean, to be fair, there's also only 7 plots, if I recall correctly. I don't remember what they all are, but there's only 7 plots in all of writing.
Yeah.
So
I can't remember what they are either. I know what you're talking about, though.
It's a literary content.
Yeah. But, you know, I mean, like, when something's emotionally manipulative, that's basically, like, saying that it's... All its purpose is to just, like, create the feels, you know? Like, that sort of thing. And there's literally no other purpose to it but to just, like, try to make you cry. Like, there's nothing else mm-hmm. there but to, like, work on your emotions.
Anohana, is that you?
All right. Let's test this.
that one gets it a lot.
That's a good one, but
yeah.
Yeah, that's.
Let's test this. Has everybody seen SAO2?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Dakota, have you seen it? Yeah. Cool.
Yeah. Okay. Sorry. All right.
Specifically, massive spoilers for SAO2 for anyone that actually cares, but the girl that dies.
Oh, yeah. We're talking Mother's Rosario, the entire arc.
Yeah, actually, a really good example.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Like, would you all consider that melodrama that is good or bad melodrama? Because I've seen it argued both ways, and I'm curious to hear your thoughts.
I think it was handled as ham-fistedly as the rest of the key plot points in Sword Art, but I think it was handled better than the rest of the show.
Yeah, I agree with that. At the same time, though, like, see, I almost want to say that it is melodrama and it is bad melodrama, but at the same time, I liked it
comparatively
more than
to
everything
itself.
Else in SAO. Like,
I mean, compared to Gun Gale and
Fairy
Dance, it's just. You know.
Yeah. What is that? What the second arc in SAO2 is called?
Sword One. Second arc in SAO1 is Fairy Dance.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
Whatever the.
That's another one.
Gun Gale is the first half.
What's the second one in SAO2? Like the middle one where they just get Excalibur or whatever.
Excalibur.
Oh. Well.
That's called filler arc.
Filler. Yeah, that's a good way to put it.
It's called the Excalibur arc, or the Excalibur arc or the Caliburn arc. I can never remember.
Are they getting Excalibur or Calibur? I don't know. I don't care.
Excalibur.
It's just terrible.
Yeah.
Excalibur.
You know, I would have taken 4 episodes of Excalibur singing over that, I think. I think it would have been better. Come at me, Reddit.
Oh, man. Wait, does Reddit like it?
I don't know.
They like the OP.
Reddit doesn't like anything. Reddit hates the world.
Quick question.
Except for SAO OPs. They fucking love SAO OPs.
They have some, like, catchy songs.
I was going to ask, is another one, another word would be comparatively. I hear that a lot, but it's being used. It's just, I hear it a lot. Like, a lot of people will compare anime to other, like, anime shows, and they'll say, in comparison to this, and it's, sometimes I wonder why they're even being compared in the first place.
Okay, I think I know what you mean. I wouldn't necessarily call that a buzzword, but a concept that definitely gets implemented a lot is not evaluating a work based on its own merits, but its merits relative to other works,
mm-hmm.
which isn't always fair. Like, for example, if I'm going to compare the visual aesthetic of a show that was animated by Zebek to anything by KyoAni, for example, like, as a concept in comments, I get where you're coming from, Dakota, where, I don't know, it just feels like they're going too far to make a point.
Mm-hmm. Instead my primary of actually explaining bugbear it. In comparativism is when we're comparing anime plot and anime in general to Western media, like Western, I guess more like art house films that are trying to be more, have like more of a specific point.
Yeah, no, that usually doesn't work. It's just like, mm-hmm. the mediums are just way too different, you know? Exactly. I also think
the generalized goals of the two medias are disparate.
Exactly.
There you go. I'm using some big words, guys. There you go.
Pretty pretentious.
You can call me a pretentious
here.
Asshole in the comments.
Yeah.
Yeah, throw it in the comments. Like, comment, and subscribe if you think I'm a pretentious asshole.
Another place I think people, you know, just comparing old stuff and new stuff, I think sometimes is just done poorly because people don't consider, you know, how much, like, the time period that something was made in completely affects, like, everything about it. So comparing something from the 70s to something from last year or last 5 years, like, it just doesn't really work most of the time, if that makes any mm-hmm. sense.
Yeah.
It's like comparing the original Macross to Macross Delta. You're not going to have a good time.
Yeah, I mean, like, so many things have changed, and not just, like, technical, you know, animation quality and stuff. I mean, even, like, just, like, the ways of storytelling have changed over mm-hmm. the last...
The generalized know, theme the cliche, of the two, you know, is also
the tropes, the archetypes
different.
that are common nowadays are completely different, you know, just everything about it. Yeah, the target audience is different. And you see it all the time. People, that's like one of the biggest debates people always seem to have is comparing old stuff and new stuff.
Oh, that's one that always gets me is old anime is better.
Oh yeah. Oh god.
That's one of my favorites.
If you type modern anime suck on YouTube, I wonder how many results will come up. Jesus. How many videos have been made with the title modern anime suck?
I mean, a lot of them are from Prof. I'm kidding, Prof. I love you. I mean it in the best way possible.
Or you know what? I have a buzz concept that bothers me. And that's just like large scale generalizations. Like mm-hmm. all moe sucks. Or moe shit.
All harem animes are bad, which I'm guilty of. Because that's not entirely true.
Hey, you like Monogatari, don't you?
I do, but that's a very non-standard harem.
True.
And we both know it.
I mean...
That's another pretentious show.
Have you seen Ouran Host Club?
I have, and that's an excellent harem.
Yeah, there you go. There's an example. I mean, you know, it just, yeah, like, generalizations like that just don't work.
Yeah.
Like, you can always find something. The moe one is easily like the most common. What drives me nuts is this idea that, like, moe is somehow, like, cancerous to the community because it's stifling creativity or something. And it's just the idea that because it's so popular, it's getting made more and more. But that's not entirely true. I mean, anything that's popular is going to get made more if they think it's going to make money, you know. But
mm-hmm. I mean, throwaway moe shows, which do exist, are kind of like the
there's a difference between throwaway huge. I mean, like, people like to lump all moe. That's the problem, is people like to lump all moe into throwaway moe shows. But K-On! Is not a throwaway moe show, you know.
Exactly.
Nananburi isn't either.
Exactly. Right.
They're kind of, the throwaway ones will always make money because they hit a target demographic. And it's kind of like rom-coms and generic horror films here in the West. It's a studio can crank out 6 or 8 of those in a year without breaking a sweat, and it doesn't really matter. They don't have to put a ton of money into them, and they'll make money on them. And then they can do something better and maybe break even.
Exactly. It's not taking that much time away from their ability to do other things.
Exactly. It's like there's two people animating. There's one person animating TQ, and how much money is it making?
Metric. Although, to be fair,
yeah, exactly. And to be fair, that's not exactly a throwaway moe-esque show.
Moe isn't. You know, the idea that moe is somehow like taking over all modern anime isn't even true. Like every season, there's obviously a handful of solid straight moe shows, but there's equally large handfuls of generic action shows and, you know, generic mech shows. You know, for every genre, you get the same throwaway stuff, generally speaking.
Yeah, you get generic shovelware no matter your genre.
Exactly. And I think moe is like the, you know, easy target because on the surface, it's just seemingly just so mind-numbing and borderline pedophilic and...
And to be fair, a lot of it is rather mind-numbing.
Yes. Yeah. It's just, yeah, no, and it goes back to what we were saying about generalizations, though. It's equating those mind-numbing examples to the whole. And, yeah.
Exactly.
It doesn't stack up. Another word that, and this isn't a criticism so much, just as a word that needs to die. And I know we're all going to agree on this. Objective.
Oh, there's no such thing. There is no such thing. I'm gonna throw that out there, guys. There's no such thing.
In every scenario it could possibly be used, objective sucks. Don't use it. If I see you use the word objective, I'm probably going to completely disregard everything afterwards.
You can have the pretension of objectivity, but you can't actually be objective because you bring in an inherent bias by being someone.
Yes.
In fact, by claiming to be objective, that is your bias. You think you are objective, but you're not.
I mean, like, first off, objectivity is boring. You don't want objectivity. Trust me.
You really don't.
Like, it's impossible. You know, like, have you guys seen that video? I forget what, but like the 100% objective review.
Yeah, I think I know.
Yeah.
I think I know which one.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's basically just like, you know, this, you know, K-On! Is an anime. It has characters that are girls in high school. They drink tea
and play music.
Yeah, exactly. No, yeah, no. It's completely horrible. And the idea that people like somehow objectivity is a good thing and being biased and subjective is bad, that idea just needs to die. Thankfully, it kind of is dying.
Yeah, it's been a long, long war.
It has, but people are like finally realizing, wait, this is fucking stupid. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
See, here's the thing. I feel like that word is only dying in this community because there's so many people championing the idea that objectivity isn't a real thing that can be applied in reviewing or discussing anime. I definitely see it in other communities. I've seen it.
Gaming community is notorious for using that word.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, basically the only time I use objective,
like what you like,
the only time I use the word objective is completely tongue-in-cheek.
Mm-hmm.
No, when it...
Or if it's in a game where I'm going towards the thing I have to do.
Yeah. Right.
That's the only objective that is acceptable.
Exactly. And that kind of like leads into like something that I just dislike in general is when people and I think Lou, I think you mentioned like this sort of thing earlier, just like when people criticize shows for things that don't actually have to do with the merits of the show. So like like saying a show is bad because you hate the fan base. That's an example.
Like, yeah.
I'm sure like everyone here has fan bases that, I mean, pretty much all fan bases suck. Like all hardcore fan bases of basically everything.
Hey man, my fans are great.
Okay. Of any
240 something of you are great.
But yeah, I mean like fan bases of almost every show to some extent suck. Like at least there are people in every fan base that suck. But holding yes. that against the show is kind of stupid. And I'm not saying like I'm not guilty of that sometimes, but cuz I am. But it's just dumb, you know. It doesn't actually make sense to call a show bad or criticize a show for something that doesn't actually have anything to do with the show itself.
Or even if it does, assumptions. When people assume things that may or may not apply to a show, but again, do it very matter-of-factly. Like, for example, shows that are 100% CG or mecha shows that use CG for their robots, assuming that those are automatically bad is definitely a thing that needs to die. It's not okay.
Yeah.
Because it disregards so many other aspects of it. So, like having certain aesthetic preferences, but just operating under those assumptions or arguing that something is automatically bad just because it has CGI. Like, for example, all the people that are complaining about the new Berserk show that's coming out, saying that it's automatically going to be shit because it's all CGI.
Oh, yeah, I hate that.
I think that's putting the cart before the horse a little bit.
Yeah. I mean, look, as one of the representatives of the mecha community, a lot of us have kind of accepted that we're just going to have to deal with not great-looking CGI mechs to get our mecha at this point, because it's just how it's going to be for the time being, and it's probably not going to change. So we're going to bitch, so like I will bitch about it in every show that it looks terrible in, but I'm still watching mecha, and that hasn't changed.
Well, I don't know, man. Fucking Cross Angie was pretty great. It looked all right to me.
That
mecha
show
is on is
that
on
show. That show is bad. You
that
want you want
so
to know how
fucking good.
You know, Dime a Dollar is better, and those are hand-drawn mechs. Although, to be fair, those mechs look fucking awful.
Nah, man, what are you talking about? It like, the mechs in Dime a Dollar finish people by fingering them.
It's very true. I'll give them that.
And, like, they fight penguins. I mean, come on.
The power of the Gulliver stick, man. Don't knock the power of the Gulliver stick.
I mean, I think we can all agree that Dime a Dollar is a 10 out of 10 masterpiece.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. Objectively speaking, it's great.
And you're pretentious as fuck if you think otherwise.
I was going to say I can say it without pretension, but I like that better.
Another example of this sort of thing is holding, you know, saying that like something from a certain studio is automatically going to be bad. Like, oh, Dean made this. Oh, it's going to be terrible.
Dean?
And that's actually like the perfect example right now. Because in the last two seasons, Dean made, let's see, the last season they made Konosuba and Rakugo. I forget what they made this season. Was it Sakamoto Desuga?
Yes.
Yeah. I have you guys seen it? Like, is it good?
It's okay.
I've heard some, like...
My girlfriend loves it.
Yeah, I've heard some
My
good
My girlfriend's real into
about
it.
I
mean, I'll be honest, Dean's been deep fucking my expectations, and my expectations have been really liking it.
Yeah.
So, you know what? I'll take
it. Well, yeah, no, I mean...
See, here's the thing.
Go ahead.
Well, sorry for cutting you off. Here's the thing. My expectations for Dean are still extremely low because they need to make up for Pupa. I watched all of that.
And CGI Dragons.
I was going to say that they need to make up for...
Never forgive. Never forget.
For Dean's Day Night.
Yeah. CGI dragons. I can live with everything else.
Yeah, CGI part. Dragons, probably like part. That's got to be one of the most infamous scenes in anime. Just God. Although they also have to make up for the Dean UBW movie. That's something I also can't live with.
That, yeah, that
it'd be kind of pointless.
The what? I'm sorry, Jack. I don't know what you're talking about. I feel like I blacked out there for a second. You mentioned another thing that they did. Yeah. I don't. I'm sorry. What?
But hey, they did Higurashi. I like Higurashi, and that has like, crap animation for the most part.
Oh, that animation is hilarious.
But exactly. Like the animation actually sort of adds to the whole aesthetic of the thing.
And she has a knife going right into her cranium. Really does.
But yeah, I mean
that OP for the first season is fucking creepy.
Oh it's god, glorious. I love it.
It's easily one of my
I listen to it on its own, man.
Yeah, same.
Good.
Higurashi's first OP. I mean, the second one is cool too, especially since it's the first one played backwards. But the Higurashi's first OP is glorious. But yeah, no, I mean, basically, it's just like Dean goes to show that lately that the idea of like dismissing shows only based on the studio that makes them is really dumb. You know, especially since like in general, the studio is only a part of the equation that goes into making a show. You know, there's much more.
They provide the financial backing.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, people like to say like, you know, the most common thing in the community people always do is just like, you know, pin shows entirely on whatever studio made them, which is generally like the only time there's only like KyoAni is probably one of the only cases where that's more true than others.
I'm gonna whip out Phantom World, buddy.
No, I just mean that like KyoAni keeps everything in house and has all their trained staff. Yeah, so I mean like all of their shows actually are done by them and by the same people, generally speaking. Even Phantom World, but you know, one bad apple doesn't spoil the bunch, you know.
Yeah, it's true. Shaft is the other studio that basically keeps effectively the same staff, if I recall. Yeah. Although that's been to kind of their detriment.
Yeah, I mean, you know, if you don't like whatever staff the studio keeps in house all the time, then obviously, you know, that changes things. But
exactly.
You don't see it. You generally don't see this with studios like Shaft and KyoAni. More often than not, we're talking about Dean and A1 Pictures and JC staff. You know, studios like that. Oh, where people are like, up.
A1 Pictures has like four different studios.
Yeah, like seeing that criticism thrown at A1, it always amuses me, and especially since I love doing it, regardless of I know that everyone in A1 is always changing. Like, basically, it's a new crop of people every time they make a show. And, I don't know. Like, I still like to bitch about A1 Pictures. They do some good shows, or they have done some good shows. But, for the most part, I don't like it.
I don't either.
They did Suritama, which is good.
What else did they do? They did Your Lie in April. They did...
I dropped that.
They did Shinsekai Yori, which I really liked.
That was pretty good.
They did Sword Art Online.
Yep.
Which, you know, for all the shit we give,
they made
Sword
some
Art,
money.
It's not the worst thing in the world.
It's not worse.
It really isn't. Like, it's Power Fantasy, the anime, but there are worse things.
A comic, a kill.
Yes. Yes.
But. No, I honestly, that's another, I would even say that goes down as one of the overused things, is that people giving SAO shit just because it's the now thing to do, or it was the now thing to do.
Oh god, hate wagoning is, I hate it so much.
Shitting on something that's popular has been around since the dawn of time.
True.
So that's never going
to
stop.
It's a cycle too, it always goes through
the
same thing.
I'm guilty of it.
It always goes through the same thing. Show starts. Show rapidly achieves massive popularity. Show quickly, all that popularity quickly turns into hate from like a select group of people that just happen to have the loudest
voices.
And their
pants drop and the shit starts to flow
exactly.
Forth.
And then, yeah. And you cannot be neutral either. That's the other catch. You have to pick a side.
Yeah, like the most recent big example of that was the reaction of certain portions of the community to Erased.
Yeah. Absolutely, yeah.
Yes.
Which, I mean, I ultimately ended up rating Erased like a 6 out of 10.
I get like a 7, but, you know.
I gave it a 6.
Like, it's an okay show, you know.
But it's solid.
But people going as far as calling it like a 0 out of 10s or like just taking that irrational hatred of it to an extreme, and then those people having loud enough a voice that other people just start parroting what they're saying.
Well, yeah, that's the thing. Is that like if you're going to say it's a 1 out of 10 and you're going to and you back up why you think so, like, okay, even if I like completely
more power to you, man.
Justify it, and I'm fine with
that. Yeah, you know, even if I disagree with you, whatever, you know, you can support your opinion. It's the people that, like you said, just parrot, you know, the opinion over and over. That's where the problem. That's where I take issue, and where it annoys me.
I've got a word that I'm kind of tired of hearing. Although to be fair, I do use it a lot.
Shoot.
Edgy.
That was on my list.
Yeah, I figured I'd whip out edgy because I'm actually going to use an example of a show that is so edgy, it's fucking hilarious. Big Order this season. Big Order is so edgy, it is hysterical. And I think it's because it knows how edgy it's trying to be and it's not taking itself seriously.
Yeah, I've heard that.
It is so funny. It is
I tapped after one episode. Best. So Lou, elaborate. Lou. What makes it edgy?
Oh my god. So, first off, I'm going to spoil the latest episode a little bit. Main character Kun totally bangs his sister. Which, like straight up, they don't even, like, disguise
adding
it.
Adding to my plan to watch?
Yeah. Yeah, Lou. Lou, it's 10 episodes. Like, he bangs his sister. Also, by the way, half the OST is, like, jazz. Like, action jazz. It's great. For no reason.
Again?
There's no reason for it. Big Order. It's done by the source material is done by the same mangaka as Mirai Nikki, and goddamn does it show.
Oh joy.
It's just the best. So, I mean, the main character, at the drop of a hat, he goes from, like, sort of unsure of himself to just, like, at the end of the first episode, just like, yeah, that's right, I'm the guy who destroyed the world. By the way, my power is OP as shit. And, yeah, I control you now. You can't kill me. By the way, you're kind of cute. You're going to marry me now.
Yeah, so basically he's a villain.
He is, but he's the hero. It's so great.
Huh.
Oh,
that kind of reminds me of, like, Overlord, in a way. Where it's like, yeah, this guy is supposed to be the villain. But, like, we're watching everything from his perspective.
Yeah, it's just... I don't know if it's intentionally trying to be like, yeah, we're so cool, man. Like, look at us. Or if it's like being like, yeah, we're so cool. We know we're cool. We know we're being a trash show. I can't tell. It's either a really good satire or it's being serious. And at that point, you can't tell the difference.
But yeah, edgy.
But yeah, edgy. I'm not like, I use that word and I'm not a huge fan of it.
Yeah. I mean, I know some of these that we've already said, like, I've been guilty of in the past, but edgy often gets confused. I mean, people just, like, often anything that is remotely dark or mature automatically gets the edgy label, and edgy's always meant as a criticism,
edgy,
too, as a slight against it.
Edgy and pretentious are usually used in the same
sentence. Yeah, definitely. Oh, yeah. Grim dark, that's another variant I see all the time.
There's only one franchise that can use Grimdark. Anybody else is lying.
And?
That's Warhammer, by the way. Warhammer is the only Grimdark.
I haven't seen it.
It's not an anime. It's a...
tabletop RPG, right?
Yeah. Okay. Well, it's a tabletop game, but there's a gigantic universe in the 40... It's in, like, the year, like... It's in, like, the 41st millennia... And, like, it's just really fucked up. Basically, everything is fucked up, and nothing is right in the world. Or the universe as it happens. And everyone's trying to kill each other, and there are no good guys. But they've been doing this since, like, I think the 80s or 90s, so they don't get the... They don't get the bandwagon hammer.
I think edgy is probably, like, the textbook example of a buzzword, though.
Yeah, it really is.
Yeah, and you just see it all the time, and even in cases where it's valid, it's just like, you know, you could easily come up with something that tells you more than just saying, oh, it's so edgy. three edgy, five me, you know.
I do use it in a mostly ironic context, but it's hard to tell if I'm serious or not in 140 characters or less. So.
Oh, I definitely don't use it in a ironic context. I'm very much serious when I call something edgy.
I usually am too.
I have no shame in that.
I think we all are.
I usually am too. My problem with edgy is just that it's probably, I just think it's just too much, and sometimes in cases where it doesn't necessarily apply. But
true.
Yeah, I mean, A Comic Got Killed falls under edgy too, like actually edgy.
Yeah.
Like trying to be edgy and failing, edgy is a legitimate criticism of that show. But for the most part, it gets thrown around on shows that just get a little too grimdark.
Yeah.
Well, just gritty in general.
So I've got another one here. I've only got a few left, which is good because we're coming up on an hour. But when people call things a bad adaptation for not being as one-to-one as they would like.
Oh, I hate that.
It's so dumb. It misses the entire point of an adaptation. You know, people read something they like, and then they hear it gets an anime, and they're like, oh, good. I want the exact same thing. I want one-to-one, completely move it to anime. And it doesn't, it just doesn't work like that. Like, the whole point, it's not a translation, you know? Adaptation is changing it for a new medium and adding things, mixing things around that would make it a better fit for said medium. And in some cases, like,
a good example of this is, a great example is this Fate Stay Night.
Exactly.
Everything that's been done in the Fate franchise has been an adaptation because there is literally no way they could do a direct translation.
Exactly.
Fate Stay Night's a visual novel. It's 100 hours long.
It's so long, and it's split into three routes, which are all, you know, they're like in parallel, you know, timelines or universes, whatever exact terminology you want to use, of each other.
I think just one run through takes you 40 hours, right? Something like that?
Depends, yeah. I mean, a lot of it depends on how, but I think it's more than that, more like 60, or depends on how fast you read, I guess, but
40 to 60.
I think the general average is 60 hours, and that's not including including the bad ends, anything like that. But
yeah, that's if you have your flow chart next to you.
But yeah, no, I mean, you cannot translate that to anime, you know, one-to-one, 100%. And so far, every Fate Stay Night adaptation, which there's only been three of them, but the recent UBW series is probably the best example. Got so much criticism from people who've read the visual novel, you know, hardcore visual novel elitists who wanted their one-to-one adaptation, and when they didn't get it, just so salty, you know?
Well, which they don't take into account that if you want to get your one-to-one adaptation, we're going to be watching Bladeworks for the next 3 years, and it's going to have entire, like, 3 or 4 months of just exposition dumps.
Oh, exactly.
Because that's
Fate Stay Night is loaded with exposition dumps, which in the context of a visual novel work. I mean, that's far more acceptable in a visual novel.
It's a fucking book.
Exactly.
Yeah,
you can
book.
Do that.
It's a book with pictures and some cutscenes.
Yeah, which, you know, but you can do that in a book. In an anime, it doesn't work. It would just, you would lose interest so fast. Yeah.
That was a problem that I had with the current adaptation, is that there were episodes of just Archer standing there talking to Rin for just 10 minutes, because in order for the next part of the plot to progress, they had to, like, fill all this shit in.
Yeah, exactly. And it doesn't help that Fate Stay Night's, like, universe and mechanics are extremely complicated, and
which is
the rules are endless.
Well,
I like about it too. Yeah. No, I mean, you either like it,
it's hard.
You either like it or you don't. I find it really interesting.
It's hard to convey in an anime format.
Exactly. You know, and that's why Fade Zero's first episode gets so much criticism, because it was 45 minutes of exposition. You know?
Well, it needed to be in order to set the damn
thing up. And I'd much rather them just get it all out of the way in one episode, in one go.
And to be fair, the other 22 episodes between that and the last couple are really good.
Yes. The ending. I will fight anybody over
I'm
the
shitting,
ending.
I am shitting on episode 25, bro.
Is that the last one?
I'm shitting on it.
Is there 25 episodes?
That's the last episode.
Well, which part?
And it is rushed to hell.
I don't know, man.
The last 8 minutes.
What else?
What
else would they have put in?
Well, they could have done an extra episode.
They showed all the things they needed to show in the last episode.
It just felt rushed.
Any episode that has as many time skips as that one did, you know. It had like
a bunch of time skips. I think
it's
it had
come off
like
really fast.
It shoved the last like three battles into I think the last 12 minutes.
In the last episode, if I recall, I don't think there were any battles in the last episode. The last like three episodes had like the entire ending in general. Like the last five episodes saw like half the servants die, whereas the previous like 20 episodes only like
not
three
much
of
happened.
Them died.
I mean, a lot happened, but not combat-wise.
Not in terms of like results. So,
I mean, the justification for that would be the buildup, and to lead to meaningful deaths, as opposed to doing what Akamaga Kill did, where they just fucking die.
Oh, yeah. I'm not. I am vaguely shitting on this show. I absolutely love it. It's probably one of my favorite shows of all time, but it has a couple issues, and that's one of my problems.
It does, and it's an example of a show.
The pacing at the end of it's not great.
It's an example of a show that, like, despite all of its issues, I just enjoyed the absolute hell out of it, and that's, like, more important.
Oh, yeah, of course.
For me, at least, you know. Okay, so I have two significant ones left that I've been saving for the end. So, first, I just generally don't like the word overrated. And the reason is mostly because of the way it's used. Overrated is not an inherent like criticism of the show. You're criticizing other people's view of the show, not the show itself. You know, like just saying this show is overrated. Tell me why it's overrated. Why do you think that other? You're basically saying that it's bad, and other people think way too highly of
it's
it.
Good.
You know, but more often than not, you know. Overrated doesn't actually tell me anything about the show itself. It just tells me what other people think about the show.
Overrated and overhyped.
Overhyped is another one, too. I am guilty as sin at using overrated.
I think
everyone is, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think we all are.
But this is kind of like what we've been saying with most of these. It's just that a lot of them don't actually tell you anything about what you're trying to criticize. And overrated might be like the biggest example of that. I guess underrated is kind of like the same thing.
The other side of the same coin. Yeah.
It's not nearly as bad because usually when you say underrated, you're just meaning that not enough people have seen it. Is usually the context underrated is used. But yeah.
Yeah, exactly. That's the context I use it in for a couple of shows. Scrapped Princess, Katana Katari. Watch them both. They're great.
I know. I need to. You've been telling me that for a while. They're on my watch.
Do it.
Exactly. I think, you know, the ultimate lesson from all this is be specific. Unless you're limited by a 140 character limit on Twitter, and if you're not limited by that and, like, you want to have a discussion with somebody or just, like, actually, like, state your opinion on something, actually, like, be specific and tell me why you have the opinion that you do. Not just use these boring, lame buzzwords.
YouTube comments allow 500 characters. We can have a good discussion.
I think some YouTube commenters can
You can even leave multiple fucking comments.
Yeah, exactly. Go for it. Chain them together.
Yep. You can also edit your comments.
Twit longer,
by
man.
By the way, some people don't seem to know that. I'll get a comment and then they'll reply to the comment with like one like typo that they made. It's like correcting the typo. I'm like, the edit button is right there, you know.
Yeah, use the edit button, man.
But yeah.
And twit longer is a thing.
Twit longer is a thing. Yes. You should definitely use it. But yeah, the last probably, and this is the one that triggers me the hardest. The ultimate criticism I just can't take because it's so stupid and is never true. When people say X show is about nothing, it's not true. There isn't a show that's about nothing.
Well, Seinfeld.
Yes, except
you're
Seinfeld.
Wrong. This,
well,
that's
yes,
a great
Seinfeld,
fucking anime that everyone should watch.
Seinfeld
it is 90s brilliance.
Corey in the house, yeah, get the fuck out. It's Seinfeld.
Yeah, I mean, Seinfeld really is about nothing, but...
Or so they say, but even Seinfeld is about
actually,
something.
More accurately, it's about the characters. Yeah. It's not about what they're doing.
Yeah, I mean, even in Seinfeld, it's, you know, tongue-in-cheekly said that it's about nothing. But it is not actually about nothing. The Moe shows get this one all the time, that they're about nothing. But even if you don't like them, they're not about nothing. You know.
Yeah, they're about Moe. Yeah,
they're about, like, you know, even the throwaway Moe shows. they're still about like cute, cute girls doing cute things and having fun, and you know, it's a relaxing, you know, potentially enjoyable time if you are into that sort of thing. But you see that. I see it all the time with It About Nothing. K-On! Probably gets it a lot. We've mentioned K-On! A few times. K-On! Always gets criticized for being about nothing. But yeah, it just doesn't make sense. I can't even think of a show that's close to being about nothing, where nothing happens the entire time.
Yeah, even if it's a show about nothing, like, for example, the characters do nothing, it still counts as slice of life, and they're still doing something. So, there's no such thing.
I have a show where nothing matters. Raka no Yusha. We're at the end of the season, nothing has changed.
Yeah. It was still, yes.
Effectively.
Yeah. Effectively. Yeah. But that's saying, that's saying something entirely different, exactly.
Yeah, it's still about something. It's just that nothing has effectively changed.
It's not that it's about nothing. It's about pissing you off and wasting your time.
Yeah.
I dropped that show in a second episode because it looked like ass.
And I finished it.
Yeah.
Much to my chagrin.
It's okay, I finished it too.
You poor bastards.
My girlfriend can attest to me raging like a motherfucker at that last episode. Like, it was ugly.
Yeah.
I don't blame you. Livid.
And no season two in sight. Not that I actually care to have one, but...
It's
sold so fucking terribly. You guys, like, seriously, if you look at the numbers, I think it only did, like, 500 units. That's it?
Yeah, it didn't shift anything because it was... It didn't appeal to the Japanese audience, per se. And it was also just... Nothing happened.
No, and my favorite part about that is... I think Pony Canyon is the licensor that picked it up in the US. And they're selling an expensive-ass collector's edition. And most of the people that like the show are broke-ass, like, high school students. Like, that seemed to be the group... or the demo that really enjoyed the show the most. And I don't think very many of them will have that much disposable income at hand.
I have a feeling I'll be picking these up on steep discount at some point. If I ever pick them up. I'd probably pick them up just for the extra shit and then, like, use the DVDs for target practice.
Oh, yeah, I mean, if I remember correctly, the box looked kind of cool.
Hey, man, cool boxes are worth $5.
Cool boxes are the quickest way to get me to drop... like $200 on a show. I'm a sucker for cool boxes.
Darker Than Black Special Edition. What?
All the Tight Moon box sets. Yeah, all the Tight Moon box sets have cool boxes.
The Yuki Yuna Wayusha boxes. Those are fucking gigantic and amazing. Yeah.
Well, those are Pony Can, right?
Yeah.
Pony Can puts up some good quality shit, but my god, are they expensive.
Yep.
But yeah, I think that pretty much covers all the buzzwords that we wanted to get to, unless you guys have something else.
Yeah.
Nah, I think we got most of them. At least the important ones.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah. This is a topic we could probably go on for just hours and hours.
Remember in high school when you had to write an essay and they said, hey, what color is this? And you said red? But then they go, hey, no, you need to write more than that. This does not apply to that. Actually tell us what you're thinking and why you're thinking it. Give us a brief description of why it's red, and we will be happy.
Yep,
exactly.
And just to clarify, we don't need you to regurgitate the definition.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, oh, it's pretentious, and pretentious means that it is self-important. You know, like... We know what the words mean. Just explain how they relate to the work. That's it. Exactly. That's all we're asking for. That's the only fucking reason why we're having this podcast, is to just foster better discussions in our respective comment sections.
Look, I'm assuming y'all have taken English, and I know that y'all is not a word, but that I'm not even from the South. That's the scary part. So I'm assuming that y'all have taken English, so you know how to do a basic analytical essay. So you know what your you know what a teacher's looking for? That's kind of what we're looking for, just not like we're not going to grade
Lou
you.
Might.
We just would appreciate, you know.
We just won't respect
I'm
you.
The not, fuck not out using... of them. I'm looking at all you bastards. All of you are under my observation. You will be evaluated and compared, and then the genocide occurs.
Also, keep them the 500 words or less, yeah, please. It's true. I don't want to read like super long comment sections. I'm just lazy.
You do not want honest. To become screenshotted and have me tweet you out. So that it's all true. The entire Twitter world can laugh at your horrible comment.
I will retweet it.
Because he does that.
I did that yesterday.
You
at
do
the
want
time
that.
The comments are the best. Like the people who comment on your videos are the best. Yeah. And by best, I mean, I can't, it scares me. But get some good juicy material.
I get some good ones on occasion. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Ray and Sheena also get some lovely, lovely comments, especially on their Fairy Tale Key unboxing video.
Those are great.
Go read that
My
comment section,
thing about
guys.
When I did
it's
the
great.
Loot Crate unboxing, it was yeah. But when I did the Loot Crate unboxing, there's people like actually arguing over what's in a box, and both of them, I'm pretty sure, didn't even get the Loot Crate. So they're arguing over what's in my box.
Well, that's pretty normal.
Oh yeah, anything with these boxes, those comment sections are always gold.
I'm looking forward to my next unboxing video because I have a gigantic loot crate to open.
Oh man,
nice.
Except I don't make videos, so you know.
This is true.
I just pretend I am pretentious in my making of videos.
Yeah, I would say that objectively, your video making process is pretty slow paced, and that pretty much sucks. Yeah.
Well, I mean, it is very slow paced because I haven't made one in about a year. So.
That's true. All right, guys. Well, we are passing about the hour
10 minute
mark here, so let's go ahead and wrap things up. I am Jack from Under the Scope Reviews again, and with me were Lou.
Yeah. What up? Lou Talks Anime. Check my shit out, Lou Talks Anime now. And with me, I'm going to go ahead and throw it to Random, because Dakota wasn't ready last time.
Good idea.
Hey guys, I'm RandomSama613 of Anime Opinions. You can find me on most social media at RandomSama613, Twitter, Tumblr, Hummingbird. I do have a Mal, I never update it, but you can add me on there if you want. Or you can find my YouTube videos from about a year ago or later at youtube.com/IHaveAnimeOpinions.
Okay, hopefully I have enough time now to figure out what I'm doing because I have such a delay because of my internet. So, yeah, if you're wondering why I haven't talked much this whole episode, it's because I'm on a delay, and by the time I do talk, I cut somebody off. So anything that I felt like I needed to say has been said. But I'm Dakota Broski. Hi, I make anime videos and anime parodies. I just try and have fun over there. You should come join me. That's about it. Love you.
Dakota turned into a robot, guys. It's okay.
Well, to us, he turned into a robot. I don't think to the local recording, he's going to turn into
a
robot. So it's going to sound. This is going to be a very strange sounding podcast.
It's an inside joke, guys. You wouldn't understand. Yeah. Oh, and by the way, if this podcast has triggered you in any way, please send all questions, comments, and concerns to my Twitter account at UTSReviews. I will gladly listen to how us criticizing these buzzwords pissed you off.
Or just leave a comment here. I mean, I think we
That's
all
true.
Read them.
I hate my fucking life.
All right, guys. See ya.
Laters.
Later.